best wide receiver in the NFL. The position has become the deepest in the league, with an array of otherworldly talent each dominating at the top of their game. You've got your Julios, your DKs, who look like they're molded out of clay. Legendary skill sets that will take over at any time, any place, anywhere. The elite of the elite can utilize those skills on repeat even when every last person in the stadium knows who is getting the ball. Some of them rely on speed, some rely on power, some rely on a blend of the two. But then, there's the one who breaks the mold and doesn't rely on either, Davante Adams. DA is arguably the premier dominant receiver force in the league. What elevates him above the others is his route running ability, but not because he can burn you down the field or punish you at the point of attack, but because he never runs the same route twice. Just about any receiver you can think of has a plan at the line, how they're going to attack a defender's alignment, leverage, and technique on a given play. But Davante uses a special type of release, designed to adapt to whatever the defender does after the play starts. He doesn't have a plan until he sees your plan. Whatever you do, he makes you wrong, and it works again and again and again. Despite the fact he's only played 6 games this year, he is the second receiver ever to have 3 games of 10-plus catches, 150-plus yards, and at least 1 touchdown. Calvin Johnson did it back in 2012, but he needed a full 16-game season. Davante still has 8 more games to go. If you take the 6 he's played, you could project his stats through 16 games to the tune of 1,800 yards, 141 catches, and 21 touchdowns, which would be indisputably the greatest wide receiver season of all time. So, the question is, what makes him and his route running so unique? Well, he uses what's called a hop release, which most coaches would curse you off the field for. He hops off the line of scrimmage, which doesn't work for 99% of receivers, because if the corner jams you while you're in the air, your route is dead on arrival, your timing is all thrown off, and you sure as hell are not gonna get open. It works for him though, because he can get his feet in the ground before the defender and can adjust his hop release in milliseconds to attack however the corner is playing him. Since many of them play a scooch technique where they inch backwards with small, rapid-fire steps, Davante reads their footwork and with impeccable timing accelerates while their feet are in midair. He doesn't have a plan. It's always based on the corner, so he's already on the move by the time they're just settling in. He uses his hop release whenever he's pressed at the line, and when he gets you off balance early, he uses that to keep setting you up as the route develops. Even when he doesn't get the ball, he can give the corner 5 different looks on just one simple play. The Packers are running cross dagger tagged with a deep spray out, where Rodgers reads right to left with Davante last in the progression. If he were first, he wouldn't have as much time to work the corner Holden Hill. But since he's last, he can give him a little extra sauce. He sees Hill is leveraged slightly outside and looks to be in a man coverage technique. Since Davante's running the dagger route, he wants to widen Hill as much as possible to open space inside. He uses his hop release to accomplish several things. Instead of immediately moving as fast as possible like many receivers, he can slow down and dictate Hill's pacing. Plus, he can sneakily attack his leverage and square him up to move him off his spot. Davante is a master at planting his foot at the perfect time. He gets it down right as Hill is in midair, so as he's speeding away from him, he's still inching back and is suddenly out of position with a ton of separation. Now his only hope to slow Davante off the line is to get hands on him, but the separation is too wide and he has to run and chase. Davante knows he can't just run his dagger route because of where he is in the progression. Plus, if he runs it too flat, Hill can cut it off. So he needs to create a better angle to later win back inside. He might not be the fastest, but the way he sells his movements within his routes makes Hill overcommit at each stage of the play. After he creates the space, he starts to sail across the field like he's running a deep over. Hill is off balance and sees this, so he knows he needs to kick it up a gear if Davante's headed deep. But then he turns back upfield like he's stemming vertical and uses what's called a pressure step to threaten Hill's positioning. Then he stems back towards his deep over path, which throws Hill a little off balance and makes him overcommit horizontally. So Davante pushes into him to gain leverage with his body and creates about 2 yards of separation. Since there's a hook defender sliding into the dagger window, he turns upfield and the ball goes over his head. But this is just one example of just one route. illustrating how many different things he'll throw at you each and every down. If you start to get a handle on his hop release, which is pretty damn hard since every play he's adapting it to attack your weakness, he still has a few tricks up his sleeve to take it to the next level. Hill is leveraged hard inside with his eyes trained on Davante, telling him he's most likely in man with no inside help and is using the sideline to squeeze the space for the throw. Now that Hill has seen the hop release a few times, Davante uses the hop skip, which initially looks like the hop, but instead of sticking hard to the outside, he keeps that foot in the air and explodes upfield. When Hill's feet are in the air, that's when Davante uses the skip. And since Hill is waiting for the right foot to come down, he gets cooked off the line. Once again, Davante creates so much separation that Hill can't get his hands on him to slow him down. He's burned so bad, check out how his body pops straight up for just a half second. It's an inefficient movement caused by his need to create speed now to catch up. Instead of racing around him, Davante stems vertically to preserve the sideline for the throw outside from Aaron. The vertical element deters Hill from squeezing the space and cutting him off. The ball is slightly underthrown, and Hill makes an incredible attempt, but Davante is that dude. If he hadn't created the space at each of the different stages in the route, Hill would be what's called in phase, where he's close enough that he can turn his eyes to make a play on the ball. But since Davante did create that early separation, he is out of phase and has to blindly play through the receiver's hands. Hill actually played pretty good coverage on both reps, but Davante uses every last bit of the separation he creates to win consistently. Most receivers do have a plan at the line, and that's not a bad thing, but it creates tendencies that defenders will study and identify, which can help them slow you down. Davante doesn't have a plan at the line. His plan is to beat your plan, whatever it is. He doesn't have tendencies because he's just attacking whatever you're doing in that moment. However, he doesn't only win because of his hop release, because he doesn't always face press. But even when he's speed releasing against off coverage, every single part of his route is perfect. Here the 49ers are playing their classic cover 3 zone and are trying to disguise it like it's man. The corner Emmanuel Mosley looks like he's in a man alignment like the first two plays we've watched, but you can see him tip it off when he starts peeking in to determine when he should zone bail. The Packers are running doubles, which is a concept we've talked about before on this channel. Rodgers knows he has the one-on-one outside, so he looks to his right to freeze the post safety and then comes back to Davante. As the ball is snapped, Mosley is dropping back into his deep third with outside leverage. Devontae's going over the top and outside of Mosley on the fade. He knows if he sets up space early in the down, he can then attack it late in the down. So he uses his eyes and body language to give a full sell inside like he's running a post or in breaking route. Receivers are coached to attack the near hip of the corner to make him uncomfortable and close the space between them. Mosley maintains his outside leverage since his cover 3 help is back to the inside, but as Davante attacks his near hip, he has to start preparing for the in-breaking route. He's still leveraged outside, but there's a ton of space along the sideline, so when Davante attacks out, he's broken Mosley's leverage and there's still a lot of room to work. As Davante locates the ball, he puts his hand on Mosley both to feel where he's going and to guide him straight up the field away from the corner. He takes his eyes off the ball to see if the safety is screaming over the top, then relocates the pass while shielding off the space he has to the outside. All the space he created early in the down was critical to him making the play. He shows incredible body control to get his elbow down with less than an index card worth of space and finishes for one of the catches of the year. What makes Davante great is just how unique he is. He came into the league and struggled his first several years, possibly due to his physical limitations. He's not the fastest like Tyreek or the strongest like Nuke, but his ability to create separation with his unique release paired with his work ethic and approach to the game are what make him great. He took a different path to greatness. He risked being different and challenged the norms that had been set before him. Davante knew to stay within himself, use what was most comfortable, and trust that he could break convention to dominate in the future. He doesn't care if his technique is right or wrong. He's in the business of creating separation. It's hard to definitively determine who is the best receiver in the NFL. There are so many external factors like quarterback ability, scheme, surrounding talent, and more. But here's what we do know without a doubt. The cornerback guarding Davante is not going to be close in coverage. When Aaron Rodgers sees DA running down the field, he knows he will be open. There will be a ton of room to make the throw. And Davante Adams is going to make the catch.